Virginia, number 0, Daniel Dixon. In the car, 6'7", senior out of Mount Sterling, Kentucky, number 4, Lamar Poets. And he coaches here for the College of William & Mary, Director of Dental Operations, Group 4. Assistant coaches are Tony Kimball, Austin Chamber, Associate Coach Jalen Holmes. And ladies and gentlemen, it's 14th season at William & Mary, the head coach, Tony Chamber.
Carpenter Center, and usually we have a whistle after the game starts. Now we have a whistle before the game starts. Make sure everybody's in the right spot. But for the final time this season, the ball is up at the Bob Carpenter Center, and they'll have to redo the jump.
Not a good toss of the ball. One of the problems that officials seem to have so often at all levels, getting enough verticality on the ball or straight up.
Delaware wins the second tip, and it's Delaware's basketball. I don't know if that was any better of a toss, but I don't want to see a third one, so we'll take it. Delaware has the rock, 10 seconds in. Running their offense with Devon Pinkard on top to Barnett. Harris, pass goes to Daly. Step back jumper over. Dixon is good. To start the night off.
Dixon is listed at 6'6", but I don't believe he's that tall, even though he's long-armed. Ryan Daly did a great job of creating some separation there on that left-to-right drive and rising up for that mid-range shot.
Nathan Knight with a pass to Dixon. Always quick to get his shot off. His Dixon got to watch out for that. Knight on the block, right side. Double team comes. McCroy knocks it out of bounds. Curtis McCroy getting his hands on the basketball early.
Great understanding of the game plan. Curtis McCroy digging in, not even off the passer, making a good play on Knight, who did not sense that McCroy was there.
12 to shoot off the inbound. Back to Cohn. Deep left side. Hedging on the screen is Harris. He gets back to defend Knight. Cohn drives, kicks out Pruitt. On top, Malinowski. 4 seconds. tonight. 2 seconds to Dixon, and the three-point shot rattles through as the shot clock was winding down.
Knight has good capability of passing out of the post, and that time Dixon just was just too quick to rise up over top of Kasman Hayes, who had great defense on him.
Barnett Harris a deep two, around and out, and a tried rebound as they bring it up the floor. Dixon with that make is now 5 of 5 this season against Delaware, 4 of 4 the first time around. Knight can't finish on a lob to the inside, around and a rebound to Ryan Daly. 18-40 first half as Daly brings it across, and it's a 3-2 lead for William & Mary. Kaz missing on a three. The senior's taking some deep shots that I don't know necessarily they would take in other situations, as two quick shots deep to start this game.
One thing Delaware's already done early on is get back on defense, because William & Mary loves to push the ball, and they're excellent at finishing.
Knight, an offensive foul as Barnett Harris doing what he does best, taking some charges, electrifying this team on the defensive side.
And the reason he does that so well, he understands the scouting report, understands how his man is going to play, and he moves his feet horizontally as well as any big man we have.
Harris getting the charge there. Mother's Sonia and father Barnett Sr. here for senior night, accompanied him onto the court earlier, very proud, out of Pennsylvania. 14 to shoot for Delaware, 2 minutes in. Hens trail 3-2. Kasman Hayes, the ball fake, crossover dribble. Now he gets himself to the foul line, even deeper. Too strong off the window, and a rebound by Malinowski. He's double-teamed, passes across half court to Knight. Pruitt with the basketball on the wing, 24 to shoot, cross court to Cohn. McCroy closes out well, now kicks it away. David Cohn dives on the floor to get it back. Hayes showing some hustle. He dives. Ball comes loose again into the hands of Dixon. His second three is up off the mark. Knight can't control. Out of bounds. Good hustle from both sides on that one.
A great job by Devon Pinkert. As he had gone down the floor, sensing the steal was going to occur for Delaware, he's got to backtrack the whole half court, gets there, gets just enough a piece of Knight before he can grab it, and goes off of Knight's hands. A really good hustle play there by Devon Pinkert.
McCroy bringing the ball up the floor. Curtis McCroy's family here as well. Brother used to play for Delaware Lacrosse, and he's in attendance. Pinkert, the corner three, that's number 100 career for Devon Pinkert.
And we talked about him loving the deep left and right corner. That was a la 4 years ago, where he rises up on the quick pass, beats the defender before he can adjust.
Delaware lead 5-3. Malinowski straightaway three, an answer for William & Mary.
A good job using the screen up top of Knight, stepping back. Malinowski, excellent range, excellent accuracy, and a really quick release.
43% from downtown is Malinowski's second best in the conference this season. 18 to shoot for Delaware, 6-5. William & Mary lead on 2 3-pointers made. Pinkley with the basketball, driving on the inside. Knight, a good shot blocker, gets around him off the window, and fires for Pinkert on senior night.
One of my favorite plays by Devon Pinkert, though he doesn't do it very often, is drive the ball. He's known as a spot-up long-range shooter. That time he drives it, takes on the shot blocker, which he could not do, and finishes at the rim.
16-24 left first half. Cohn squares up for a three after a pass for Malinowski, and all three buckets from the drive have been downtown. It's 9-7, William & Mary.
Cohn has not shot it as well from the three-point line as he would have liked this season, but he's a great distributor and a very timely shooter, knows how to create space.
Very good transfer player as Daly kind of off balance and have good grip of it as he shot it. Goes out of bounds. Harris trying to save it. He does so off of Daniel Dixon. So the Delaware basketball quickly returns. Good start for both teams. 9-7 is the score. William & Mary on top, 15-59. First half of basketball.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
That's right, Clarence. give us a call at 453-1500.
This is Blue Hens Country, 94.7 WDSD.
15:59 to play in the first half. It looks like Martin Inglesby will go back to a normal starting five now as substitutions come in, pushing Carter Mosley, Bryant on the floor now to join Ryan Daly as Delaware started four of the seniors. And I love that tradition, getting a start from your friends and family on senior night. But now starters on the floor for Delaware after the timeout.
And Jack Whitman also in for William and Mary. They had started Nathan Knight, which might be a kind of a smart play by Coach Tony Shaver, just to allow that young man to get into the flow of the game. Here comes William and Mary in their zone.
Knight, a rebound and assist in 4 minutes to start things off. As Bill mentioned, zone defense now for the Tribe, as Delaware has 17 to shoot. To the foul line goes Cushing behind him. Carter was open for a moment, but Whitman gets over in time as the pass goes through. Mosley going to penetrate inside of the zone and misses at the rim. Mosley's been shooting very well from the field as of late. 56%, in fact, over the last seven games for Champ. On the dribble drive, Malinowski to Dixon. He has one three-point shot in, make it two, this time from the corner, left side.
The help was drawn by the fact that Malinowski got in so deep. And you've got to understand, when William and Mary drives that deep, they're going to be passing out. That's what Cone does. That's what Malinowski does. And when Birchfield comes in, they try to set up the shooters on the perimeter.
6-0 run for the Tribe on 2-3 corners. Daly a three over Dixon, an answer from Ryan Daly.
Well, Ryan Daly also has a very quick release, and he's really figured out how with a 6'4" frame to get the shot off against taller defenders.
Tribe lead 12-10, a miss by Cohen as he got inside, can't save it. Whitman throws it over to Bryant as he was looking for a teammate but found a white jersey. Mosley in the corner to Cushing, dropped the ball, now drives baseline as he gets it back. On top to Mosley, Daly jab step into the corner, right side, 19 to shoot for Bryant, his first touch. Offensively, a screen comes from Eric Carter, bounce pass to Carter, cross-court pass to Mosley, who decided to cut and leave the spot the ball went. A turnover.
I love the fact that Anthony Mosley was cutting in from the weak side. There had actually been help across from that side of the court by the William & Mary defense, and Eric Carter did the right thing. He just threw the pass a little behind and a little too hard. Smart, though, weak side flashing by Anthony Mosley against that zone.
First turnover for Delaware. Pruitt with the ball inside, Cushing defending. He tucks right-handed hook shot through the lane. Is tough, but in. For Omar Pruitt.
Pruitt has a lot of versatility to his game. He can post up. He's a three-point shooter. Loves to drive the ball and shoot off the dribble. Understood that he had a freshman Cushing on him and attacked him through the post.
A lot of CAA coaches can't wait for his senior night, that's for sure. He's been a star in this league since his rookie campaign. 14 to shoot for Delaware. Bryant on the dribble drive. To the left hand. Off the window score over Omar Pruitt.
Darian Bryant got just enough of a first step and a little bit of a hip and Omar Pruitt as he beat him at the basket.
14-12, Tribe lead by two. First touch for Rowley, who just checked in the game. Dixon has two threes and the basketball. Inside to Whitman. Whitman, power dribble. Carter's there to defend. Good defense by Eric Carter. Missed shot. Jack Whitman and a rebound for Ryan Daly. Daly's first board. Cross-court pass. Corner. Bryant squares. Fires. Does not connect. Daly and Orev. Push shot is too short, and a rebound to Daniel Dixon as Daly gets back on defense. Dixon eyes up the floor, pass to Rowley, head fake on a what would have been a deep three. Cone on the wing right side, on top to Dixon. He drives right past Bryant to the rim, and he's fouled. We go to the foul line for the first free throws of this contest.
The ball reverses so quickly by William and Mary that if your defense isn't prepared for it or down in a good guarding position, they're going to be able to beat you off the drive. And that time, Dixon understood that Bryant was already working one way. He just attacked very quickly back to the weak side. And he's so explosive in his first couple of steps that he's very difficult to defend once he goes to the basket unless you have help properly positioned.
It's a first foul on Eric Carter. First on Delaware, pretty clean game thus far, almost 7 minutes in. Daniel Dixon, a very good free throw shooter, 86% break for Delaware. He missed his first, makes his second. 3-point lead for William & Mary. First shot that's gone through that was not from beyond the arc. Here's Bryant. To Pinker to just check back in. Jacob Cushing to the bench. Daly a three in front of the William Mary bench. Misses long into the hands of Eric Carter. And Pruitt poked it away, but Mosley comes up with it after nearly a steal. Daly driving baseline to Bryant on the wing. Back to Daly. Good two-man game. The pump fake and layup through for Ryan Daly.
Driving through on the baseline, Daly kicks it out. Bryan immediately drives it and returns the pass. As you mentioned, a proper use of the bounce pass. Really good two-man game there between Daly and Bryan.
Drive up by one, 15-14. Dixon to Pruitt. Catch, shoot, three is short. Rebound by Eric Carter for Delaware.
A lot of activity by Eric Carter at both ends, doing a good job of hedging, a good job of running down rebounds, and he's been very active screening down at the offensive end.
Carter looking for the ball underneath. They go to him, but it was knocked out of bounds by Oliver Tott coming off the bench, and Delaware will throw it in left baseline, 18 to shoot.
Love that concept. That's a little for big. Ryan Daly screening the big defender on Eric Carter. Eric Carter coming low. He's going to get a good post-up position every time with that maneuver.
Mosley will toss it in to Darian Bryan, who's been playing his best basketball late in this season, finally fully healthy. The transfer from George Washington, redshirt sophomore for the Hens. Nine to shoot as Pinkert has it on the elbow left side. Mosley baseline, crossover dribble to Bryant with four to shoot. Three on the way, around an out rebound by Daniel Dixon. He wants to push ahead, Oliver Tott. He'll wait for his teammates. Inside to Pruitt, didn't wait long. Pruitt was open underneath, and the assist for Tott.
Dixon made the play by busting out with the rebound, which he's very capable of doing. Then a nice entry pass to Tott. Pruitt understood no Delaware defender was underneath, got himself positioned perfectly.
Daly in the corner as Delaware works the ball around the perimeter, ends in the hands of Pinkert, and Pinkert has made another one. Pass it in on senior night, and he's got eight of Delaware's 17 for time.
Pruitt had the defensive assignment, was not aggressive enough closing out the bond.
William Mary with the basketball now, tie score. 11-12, we'll take a break at the next whistle. Pruitt inside to Whitman, Carter defends, Whitman to the baseline. He got away with the travel, missed the layup as Ryan Daly comes away with a defensive rebound. Up the court he goes. Mosley, baseline, wraparound pass in the corner, and a whistle and a foul's going to be called on the block against Daniel Dixon. We'll take a break. The score knotted at 17, 10:57, first half of basketball from the Bob Gardner Center in New York.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one Special Edition? Because actually, there's five.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Helping you rebound when things go wrong. But also here to help life go right. Team up with an agent today at 800 Steve Farmer.
Welcome back to Delaware Men's Basketball.
I'm Scott Clarkson alongside Bill Harmon here at the Bob Clevenger Center in the Newark County for 7WBSD-FM. On our listeners at St. Francis Healthcare is the official hospital of Delaware Athletics. At St. Francis Healthcare, they provide a higher level of care to better serve Blue Hens fans and the community. Learn more about the official hospital of Delaware Athletics at stfrancishealthcare.org. Right now, Delaware being led by Devon Pinkert, who has 8 points. He would be CAA Player of the Year if he played against the Tribe every game. He was 6 of 13 from the field down in Williamsburg, 5 of 6 from 3 against the Tribe. He's 2 of 2 tonight from 3-point range. That makes him 7 of 8 this season from downtown against the Tribe.
And these are all good shots. They're shot in rhythm, and he's getting to his favorite spots on the court. Very smart game played by Devon so far.
Inside Carter, behind the defender, he throws it to Mosley. Mosley's pass out to Daly, deflected and out of bounds. It'll stay with Delaware 19 to shoot, tie score.
Eric should have shot that ball. He had 4 feet. He's trying to pass on the baseline to a cutting Anthony Mosley, who had bigs around him. Work on that jump hook that he's been so capable of scoring with.
Against his Tribe zone defense, Pinkert on top, a couple dribbles to the left. They angle it into Carter. Another chance to get that shot off that Bill just described, and it goes through for Eric Carter. Delaware up 19-17.
And even with the long Nathan Knight at 6'10", Eric Carter with perfect position. He got great depth and a nice bounce pass that he could catch and rise up on.
Pruitt straight away looking to pass. Finds his teammate Tott on the wing left side. Nathan Knight screens. They can't get it to him. Rally in the corner on the left side. Driving baseline. Pickard reached in and got called for the foul, his first, team second.
William & Mary relies on spacing and court balance. They do a good job of spreading because you have to defend them because of their three-point shooters. And then they'll go into the post, though, and many times they'll also use the post up at the high key level to pass the ball and make cutters off of it.
Todd, tonight, wide open for the slam. That happened six or seven times against Delaware on the road where they would just lose a big man underneath on that screen and slip, and that was the result that time.
When you have defenders on the front side of the court and they run pick and roll on the weak side, somebody has to end up on the wall to confront that, or you just don't have enough of a numerical advantage there.
It was one on none, and a dunk for Nathan Knight ties the score at 19. Pinker with the basketball, foul line to Carter, back to Mosley. Carter sets a screen for Champ. It goes to the wing. Bryant driving on Pruitt, tucks, floats, misses, and a rebound for Nathan Knight.
Good move by Bryant. It might have been better off at once in a while to get in there with a jump stop, and he might be able to drop the ball off too, Eric Carter.
Oliver Tott driving inside, another reach against Delaware. Ball's on the floor when the whistle was called. I believe it'll go against Ryan Daly on the reach, and he was helping out Pinkard's man. The third foul on Delaware, first on Daly, the freshman from Ardmore.
When you're told to aggressively close out long-range shooters, the response by the offense is to drive the ball, and William & Mary's done a good job of adapting to what Delaware's doing to him.
Pruitt will be the inbounder, right baseline, reset shot clock for William & Mary. 9:31 to play first half, 19-19 the count, as Malinowski gets it to Tott on the wing. Knight posting up against Carter, turns and faces, about 15 feet out, takes a jumper on the baseline, missing, and Carter tracks down the rebound along the foul line.
Good job by Eric Carter just confronting Nathan Knight. I'm not sure that's a shot he's really ready to make when he's confronted by a taller player.
Carter's got three rebounds in 7 minutes of action. 16 to shoot for Delaware, approaching the 9-minute mark as they work the ball around the arc. Daly dribbles in, pass to Carter. Carter standing where Knight was on the other end of the floor. Backs him down now, and his pass is deflected. Goes into the backcourt. Pruitt gets to it first as Pinkard was tracking it down as well. A turnover for Delaware. That's their second. In the corner, Birchfield. The foul line, Knight. Good ball movement ends with Tott on the block. Kick out to Malinowski. A three-point threat. He misses, though, from the right corner. Another rebound for Ryan Daly. He's got four of those.
Really good defense there by Jacob Cushing, closing out with a wonderful high hand and the correct hand to bother Malinowski's release.
Ryan Daly needs three more rebounds for the all-time freshman record. He already got the scoring record on Thursday night, passing to Von Sadler. Inside to Carter. Backing down Knight, another turnover for Carter. That's his third, unfortunately. And Tott on the run out, fouled by Cushing. Cushing saved a layup, but Tott will go to the stripe for two.
Transition defense and offense right now, really the two components that are occurring. William & Mary off steals and long rebounds are going to push the ball. Delaware's got to make sure they sprint back and at least show in the lane additional players. Pruitt is very unselfish in the open court and has a really nice feel for which pass and how to deliver it.
Crowd making some noise is Oliver Tott's first free throw goes in. We'll see Sky Johnson check in for Eric Carter. Didn't have Sky available on Thursday. He had the flu, feeling better. Good to see Sky upright, feeling good. He was at the game on Thursday, just not dressed. And we'll see Casman Hayes check in as well.
It was that flu bug that was going around. A lot of kids down at the university have had it. Sky actually recovered a little bit more quickly than he thought as I talked to him in the pregame.
Second free throw, no good from Tott. 20-19, approaching the 8-minute mark. Has fouled by Oliver Tott at 8:01. And that's the third foul on William & Mary. Delaware has four of those.
Well, Delaware's got to be a little careful as William & Mary adjusts to what Delaware's doing, running some of their circle motion. They've been getting out of the passing lanes and cheating. That turnover by Eric Carter was because Omar Pruitt had dug in about a half a man and then did a good job with his long arm securing it.
Pinkard has eight. Can't get his 10th point as he leaned into one from about 18 on the right side. A rebound to Dixon. His pass to the newly inserted Justin Pierce. Now he gets it back, drives. Daly strips it from Knight and a tie-up. Although the arrow pointing to William & Mary, I believe William & Mary called a timeout. I believe William & Mary called a timeout to prevent the jump ball being called. We'll take a break with the Tribe. 7:44 remaining in the first half. And a close one. Tribe up 20-19.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one special edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Alongside Bill Harmon, you're listening to 94.7 WDSD-FM. And a good one so far on senior night. One of the seniors for the Hens, Devon Pinker, leads away with 8 points. Daly has seven. Seven for Daniel Dixon, 4 points for Omar Pruitt. For William and Mary, it's Tribe basketball as we return to action. 7:44, first half. Malinowski gets the pass to Knight on top. Sky Johnson defends to Dixon. Couple of dribbles, it goes to Cohn in the corner, back on top to Dixon, the senior. Pierce looking inside of Malinowski, nothing there. Knight drops the pass, it goes to Cohn, comes our way. I'll dribble a couple times and throw it to Bernard Click. That's turnover by William Merritt.
I was really surprised there. David Cohn is too experienced. When you're not sure, just go grab the ball. Why wouldn't you? Now it's Delaware's ball, inadvertent. Now you can see why Nathan Knight has some difficulties. His hands are not particularly good right now.
Second turnover of the night for William and Mary. Daly dribbling inside the arc, now back beyond the arc. Gets a pass from Sky Johnson, dribbles back into the foul line. He's trying to find his shot, can't. Good defense by Malinowski there. Tend to shoot for Champ Mosley. Straight away to Kasman Hayes. Hayes on the dribble drive. Right in the shot blocker. Knight, he's fouled. That's the second on the freshman Knight.
And that's exactly how you do want to attack a shot blocker. One thing Nathan Knight does is he's mobile and moves his feet. But if you can get him a little off balance and you attack the chest, that's the best way to do it. A smart play there by Kasman Hayes on that left to right drive.
Kaz got the start tonight, averaging 8.2 points per game. Still the Delaware's third leading scorer on average on the season. And the free throw good. We're tied at 20. This is the third time the score has been tied. Already seven lead changes in this game, 13 minutes in.
Coach Inglesby was just talking to Ryan Daly. He's going to give him a quick breather here about how to come off that ball screen. I like that Daly kind of probes coming off it. Once in a while it's fast and it's kind of medium tempo, and then sometimes it's really slow, and I think it makes him very difficult to guard because he uses a variety of techniques with the ball screen.
Hayes makes both free throws, and the eighth lead changes. Delaware back on top, 21-20. I love that he told us that he watches Steve Vistoria and other players come off of screens. That's not something a guy his age usually does in his spare time, watching basketball, learning, a student of the game, and that's one of the reasons he's had so much success. Malinowski, an elbow jump shot, left side missing, pushing a rebound. Darian Bryant will walk things up under seven, first half.
Delaware were very fortunate there. We had a defensive communication breakdown. Malinowski wide open for a shot that he normally makes.
Kasman Hayes, Cushing, baseline, drives right past Malinowski with the hammer.
We have seen Cushing become very confident attacking on the baseline, and he is an underrated athlete. That was a very explosive finish.
Inside to Dixon. Tribe looking for an answer. Down three. A three-pointer by Cohn. Around the rim and out. Darian Bryant wants to push. He'll slow things up as he approaches the timeline.
We had nice ball movement on the last possession as well. A setup Cushing reversing the floor with the pass versus the dribble.
Hayes to Darian Bryant. Delaware their largest lead at three. Six-minute mark, first half, as Bryant brings it to the right side. Picks up his dribble, looking for help. Cushing straight away with seven to shoot. Back door to Bryant, stolen away by Daniel Dixon. Good idea, but a better defensive play by the senior Dixon. His pass to Malinowski, foul line, jump shot wide open, but off of the rim and off of the mark. A foul going to be called against Justin Pierce, crashing in to Kasman Hayes.
Malinowski occasionally gets disconnected with his elbows. Really good shooters have their elbows very close, which allows them to align themselves better. That time his left elbow flared out and he missed the shot. One thing I was going to say is, of all the teams to try to run back doors against, William & Mary, who is just such a huge component of their game, they're going to be pretty good at playing it. Good concept, but you've got to understand who you're doing it against.
Yeah, I think they don't practice that every day against their own offense, of course. And a turnover for Delaware on that last possession. But Tribe are 0 of their last five from the field. Delaware trying to extend a three-point advantage. Champ straight away. Cone defense on him. Kasman Hayes to three from the wing. Back iron, no, and a rebound for Daniel Dixon. His fifth rebound to go along with 7 points to lead the Tribe in both categories. Inside, a quick transition layup for Omar Pruitt. Assist, Malinowski.
And that's the second time Pruitt has beaten the defense back down the floor, and he circles in and almost hides and then appears, and his teammates know where to look at him. And the key is Dixon with the bust-out dribble.
23 points for Delaware, 22 for the Tribe. Carver going to check in at the next whistle, and Daly will as well. He gets up off his seat. Sky Johnson over to Hayes. Hayes driving on Pruitt. Off the window, off the mark, tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Sky Johnson, and Kaz forcing things a little bit on senior night.
Pretty good job of leveling him off was Malinowski on that. Did a good job of chesting him up but not fouling. And what he did was drive Kasman away from the basket at an angle that he could not recover and get the ball to bank in.
Hayes now has made only 10 of his last 47 shots over the last 9 games. He has struggled down the stretch of his last year wearing blue and gold. He'll go to the bench. Daly back in. Carter back in. Dixon, a quick release on the three. He's got 3 triples and 10 points, the first in double figure.
When you cover Dixon, you've got to be much more connected to him. You've got to cheat the backside. Darian Bryant, just too much space there for Dixon, who is as good at a catch and release player as there is in the conference.
Cushing missing on a three, but a foul will go against Delaware on the rebound attempt. It's Eric Carter's second foul. So he just checked back in, picks up Delaware's fifth, his second.
Eric Carter using his hands as opposed to his body there to try to get block out position on the weak side. I believe that was Whitman that he literally pulled down. I love the aggression by Eric, but he's got to stay kind of composed and just get good physical position and not try to use your hands to outmaneuver your opponent.
25-23, Tribe on a 5-0 run. As Malinowski gets to Dixon, can he make another one? Yes, Daniel Dixon, the second leading scorer in the CAA, knocks it down.
I think Delaware almost needs a timeout here to talk about the defense. It's some very clever movements off the ball by Daniel Dixon to get open, Scott.
3:59 to go, and Delaware will do just that. Tribe on an 8-0 run. We'll take a break with the Tribe leading over Delaware, 28-23.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
94.7 WDSD.
Back here at the Bob Gardner Center where William & Mary is on an 8-0 run thanks to Daniel Dixon, the CAA's second leading scorer. As much as we said Devon Pinker likes playing against William & Mary, I think Daniel Dixon feels the same way against playing against Delaware. He has now made 8 three-pointers on 9 attempts this season.
Darian Bryant's just going to have to get a little bit closer to him. He's got to read the screens better, a step closer, a high hand, and try to run Dixon off the line.
See what Delaware can do coming out of a timeout. Daly, a deep two, missing. Harrison, offensive rebound, goes back up and draws the foul. An excellent board by Barnett and Harrison. They'll go to the free throw line where he's tied with Champ Mosley for the team's best free throw percentage.
One of the weaknesses of that smaller William & Mary line, even though they do block some shots, they don't get as physical on the glass as they need to. Barnett Harris just out-hustled, out-aggressiveness the front line of William & Mary on that play.
Harris taking his time at the free throw line. And he misses the first. That one rattles in and out.
I think we jinxed him.
Yeah,
76%. Him he was our
That's
best
right. We
were
talking with Barnett Harris. I think he knew what he was shooting, actually, which he takes a lot of pride in his free throws, as he should.
And the other great thing, Scott, he loves to pass out of the post.
He misses both free throws, though, and Delaware still trails by five. 28-23, 35, first half. Daniel Dixon, who's had the hot hand inside to Cone. Kick out Malinowski, another three on the way. That one rattles in and out, but a rebound. Whitman, he had Mosley defending him and took advantage of the height.
We got caught because of where Cone caught the ball, and then he kicks it out to Malinowski. That sent Barnett Harris out to try to contest the shot. Nobody open underneath. I mean, nobody underneath to block out Whitman.
A 10-0 run now. Delaware led 23-20. Spinning baseline is Harris. His shot block will get a chance at redemption from the stripe where he just went 0-2.
What a nice quick move along the baseline, turning to his right shoulder. Barnett is a lefty, as we have well documented throughout his career, and did a nice job of finishing, trying to finish, and then Whitman with the foul.
Seventh on William & Mary. Barnett Harris at the free throw line. Delaware on the wrong side of a 10-0 run right now. Over the last 2 minutes, Delaware has not scored in 3 minutes and 17 seconds. And it'll stay that way. 0-3 from the stripe is Barnett Harris, and this is a rarity for Barnett Harris. Again, a 76% free throw shooter. He scored 32 points on the season. Played well in 13 minutes against William & Mary down in Williamsburg. A little bit of everything. 4 points, 3 steals, 2 blocks against the Tribe in that one. Makes an adjustment and makes his fourth free throw of the night. He makes his fourth attempt. 1 of 4 he goes, and he'll check out, but he stops what was a 10-0 run. First points for Delaware in quite some time.
And Delaware go very small here, kind of matching the lineup of William & Mary.
30-24. Tribe leading. Under 3 to play now. Omar Pruitt with the basketball. Double teamed by Pinker. They throw inside to Rally, and he's held up by Devon Pinker. Pinker just, he hedged on the screen and didn't get back inside quickly enough. They found Rally inside, and the foul goes against Pinker.
When you're going to hard hedge a high ball screen like that, you've got to have some help, or you're going to be strung out because you just can't beat the pass, which is going to occur so much faster than your foot movement. So Delaware's got to hang in the lane until Devon Pinker can recover.
Rally, the redshirt sophomore from Virginia, good free throw shooter at 82%, makes the first. Second free throw good as well. 32-24 is the count. And this William & Mary's largest lead thus far. Let's see if the Hens can't play a solid final 243 before heading to the locker room. Jacob Cushing on the dribble drive. Cut off at the foul line. Now Bryant penetrating. Good defense by Birchfield that time. Pinker, he drives on Rally, starting at the left wing. Brings it back out. Bryant gets a screen from Pinkert. 9 to shoot. Pinkert, head fake on a 3. Now he drives to the rim. Stops, floats, good. Double figures for Devon Pinkert. He is 4-5 from the field. Cone in a hurry on the other side. As the Hens back within 2 possessions. Pruitt trying to change that with a 3. Does so.
Miscommunication on a pin down screen on the weak side. They couldn't get Cone to take the ball to one side or the other. He kept it in the middle. That makes denying very difficult.
Omar Pruitt, his first 3-pointer of the game. William & Mary has made 7. A high scoring team, and a foul going to be called against Darian Bryant. Illegal screen as he kind of nudged Jacob Cushing's defender before the dribble handoff.
As he made the handoff, he was still moving, so it acted like a moving screen. The defender was trying to get over the top. One of the defensive maneuvers that William & Mary likes to do. Sometimes they switch likes, other times they get over the top.
Tribe can get a lead in double figures for the first time tonight with a bucket here, and the corner 3 off the mark from the hands of Paul Rowley. A rebound for Ryan Daly. He goes on top to Pinkert. Pinkert, the only Delaware Blue Hen in double figures. Picks up his dribble to Champ. Champ driving. Small lineup for Delaware. No inside presence against his tribe man-to-man. Daly guarded by Dixon. 12 to shoot. 124 to play first half. Daly a head fake. Pinkert will release on the three. That's off the mark. He's had the hot hand so far tonight, though. A good-looking shot from Devon Pinkert. Pruitt on the run. Nobody stops ball. Dixon inside. Good plus one. And William and Mary up by 11. Their largest mark of the night.
Even though Delaware got back, they allowed Pruitt to get too deep with the initial foray with the dribble. And then Dixon along the baseline, just so explosive. I thought Jacob Cushing did all he could do there to try to deny him the access to the basket. But Dixon just explodes up through him.
Second foul on Cushing. Eighth foul for Delaware. Dixon does what he does at the free throw line, makes shots. And he makes it 38-26. This is a game where the lead went back and forth for the first 13 minutes or so. But Tribe have been in control since. An 18-3 run for William & Mary over the last 4 minutes of basketball. 60 seconds left in the first half of the Bob Carpenter Center. Pinkert backing down the point guard. Cohn has a height advantage. Kicks out to Cushing on the wing. Daly. Jab step on Dixon. Trying to drive. Good defense by Daniel Dixon. Rush shot by Daly. Can't track down his miss. Out of bounds it goes.
Nice spin move by Ryan Daly to get by Dixon, but he was still going a little too horizontally, just couldn't get completely on balance there to finish the shot. But I like the fact that he's trying to attack. I think when he gets a shorter player on him, not Dixon, but if he gets Birchfield on him, they ought to post him up inside.
46 seconds left in the first half as Cohn lets the ball roll to save some time. They might be going for 2-for-1 here. Birchfield on the wing on top to Dixon. They work around the arc. Cohn sees an opening kick ball by Harris. It'll stay with the Tribe. 35.9 remaining in the first half, 20 to shoot.
They've got some quick hitters, and I think they were definitely going 2-for-1, but Delaware did a good job of staying in the passing lanes there, not allowing the ball to penetrate.
Pruitt inbounds to Cohn. Cohn with a pass back to Pruitt, the inbounder. 16 to shoot for Cohn. To Birchfield. Bounce pass in the corner. Dixon crossover to the rim. Stripped out of bounds. And it'll be last touch by the Hens. Good defense back-to-back on this possession.
Excellent job by Anthony Mosley. Delaware's in a 2-3 zone. He was digging in. Did a great job there to knock the ball away from Daniel Dixon. Mosley's defense has gotten better the last three or four games. Very alert.
Birchfield with 8 to shoot. Dixon with 6. Deep right side is Birchfield. 4 to shoot for Connor Birchfield. He's stripped. Ball knocked loose. Shot clock violation. Delaware solid defense. 3 inbounds for the Tribe. And each time Delaware got the hands on the passing lane.
Great job there by Delaware in that zone to kind of transition where it almost looked like man on the perimeter. That's the second time David Cohn should have caught the ball and he let it go out.
Well, we know how well Delaware does at the end of the second half. In buzzer-beating situations, we'll see if they get a basket to head into the locker room with. Mosley to Daly. 2 seconds. Forces one up, back, iron. Can't get the friendly bounce. And Delaware down by 12 at the half. They led 23-20. And an 18-3 run by the Tribe finished off the first half of basketball. A lot of work to do for the Hens in the second half here on Senior Night, Bill.
I totally agree with you. One thing, it's got to get better, transition defense. Pruitt has really hurt us in the open court with great runs and Dixon pushing the ball. And I've got to see us go back inside to Eric Carter and others and try to at least initiate our offense through the post. That was something we talked about with Coach in the pregame, something we both thought, and we've done very little with that so far.
William Mary shooting 50% from the field, 54% from three. Delaware just 36% from the field, and they're only 3 of 11 from downtown. Delaware, William Mary, final time here at the Bob Carpenter Center this season. It's halftime, and we'll take a timeout. It's the Blue Hens Halftime Report presented by the International Brotherhood Electrical Workers Local 313. Josh Durr back in the WDSD studios with scores from around college basketball, the CAA, and the Blue Hens Sports Report. It's all coming up. William Mary, 38, Delaware, 26 at the break.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one special edition? Because actually there's 5.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Let me get a pick, pick two. Can I get a pick, pick two?
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. Mick Pick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Let me get a pick two. Can I get a pick two?
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. Mick Pick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Daly, the Tide will keep their starters on the floor. Malinowski, Dixon, Knight, Pruitt, and Cone to start the second half. Tribe will go left to right as we see it. Seated across the Delaware bench, Tony Shaver, the head coach of William & Mary. Martin Inglesby, the head coach of Delaware. And we are underway in the second half. William & Mary up by 12.
I think they're starting Knight to give them a little bit more bulk inside to combat Aaron Carter.
Dixon, he's got 16, and he's got a foul called against Ryan Daly as he dribbled baseline, go to the free throw line for the third time tonight.
Dixon is explosive in his first step. He gets a great advantage on the defender by stepping and putting the ball out in front of him. Ryan Daly tried to rotate, but it was just too late.
Dixon had 36 points against Old Dominion, a former CAA team, but currently in Conference USA, and he's pacing pretty well today to hit a high mark as he makes the free throw, gives William & Mary 39. The second free throw puts him at 40, and 18 points for Daniel Dixon. So the Hens down by their largest margin to start the second half, 40-26.
Get some more movement here on the wheel entry.
Mosley hangs, clutches, scores over the shot blocker, Nathan Knight.
He's got an uncanny ability to find the right angle and the height to release the ball against a very good shot block.
Malinowski wide open on the other end for three. In and out. That ball was halfway down before it got loose. Mosley across half court after the rebound by Eric Carter. Mosley a crossover. Daniel Dixon, solid defense all night. Back door. Great pass by Carter, but it slipped out of the hands of Darian Bryant. That was a gimme that Delaware has to have if they want to get back in this one. And on the break on the other end, Malinowski a layup, a four-point swing in a matter of seconds.
The fourth time that Delaware has been beaten down the court. William & Mary great in transition. That was part of the scouting report. Delaware not adjusting.
40-30 is the count. Excuse me, 40. The scoreboard wrong here. They gave points to the wrong side. 42-28 the count for William & Mary as the ball goes into the corner, at least tries to get there. A turnover Daly on the run out. It's Pruitt, three on one behind the back pass, some razzle dazzle, and Delaware needs to sit down. They did not bring it to start this second half, and Coach Inglesby wants to talk to his crew. We'll take a break. 18-32, a lot of basketball left. Tried lead 44-28.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center, where Delaware trails 44-28. The Tribe, after a behind-the-back pass from Omar Pruitt to Daniel Dixon, sent Delaware to the bench. A timeout by the Hens as they are struggling to start this second half of basketball. I'm Scott Klatskin alongside of Bill Harmon, Josh Durr producing back in the 94.7 WDSD studio, your home for Blue Hens Sports. You know, we talked about the four seniors that were honored prior to the start of this basketball game. Curtis McCroy, Barnett Harris, Tasman Hayes, and Devon Pinker. Those are the four basketball players, but seniors that don't always get the accolades. We do a lot of things behind the scenes. Austin Van Turin and Zach Park, two of the managers on this basketball team that do a whole lot to help this squad get ready for every basketball game. And Jake Stoner on Paul Lowry's training staff, also a senior. So Austin, Zach, and Jake, congratulations on your senior night as well.
I know Austin personally. He helped out at Wilmington Friends School this year in football. He's a great young man. If he decides to coach, he's going to be a fine one.
Delaware back in action. They go back door this time. Bryant handles the pass but couldn't get the shot up as he brings it back beyond the arc. 16 to shoot for Delaware. Hesitation dribble inside to Carter. Knight is there. He powers up over Knight. Gets the basket. Plus one for Eric Carter, and we want to see a whole lot more of that.
Eric played through contact. Knight, a big-bodied, even though he's a freshman, he's very physical. Eric confronted him, uses his left hand, develops a soft touch after he's bumped, and has a chance for what I call a real three-point play, and I like that offense. Darian Bryant came down and was looking for Eric Carter the whole way.
A real three. We are so old school, Bill. He gets.
I'm just maybe old, Scott.
He gets the three-point play. The old school way with a free throw. Delaware down 44-31. Nice effort by Carter there. He's got 5 points in 10 minutes, 2 of 2 from the field. We'd like to see the ball go into Carter a little bit more. Pruitt working on cushion, and he was shoved before the shot. Shot does not fall, but a foul going to go against Delaware, and I believe that'll be against Jacob Cushing, which will be his third and the second on Delaware.
It's the second time Pruitt has posted up Jacob Cushing, and Jacob has pretty good position, and he's got a bigger frame than Omar Pruitt, but he's playing a little too tall. He's got to sit down, use his chest to ward Pruitt off, make Pruitt try to score over top of him.
Cushing reminds me of the frame that Omar Pruitt had his freshman year. And we see how much bigger, more muscle Omar Pruitt has put on it in 3 years of basketball at William Mary. Similar builds between those two.
And I really like Cushing. Cushing moves extremely well. He's explosive off the floor. He's got that great-looking three-point shot. He's going to be a very fine player, and he's evolving every day.
Pruitt makes one of two. It's 45-31 as Daly dribbles inside the arc. Now back out in front of the Delaware bench. Back door. Carter's done some terrific passing so far today as Daly is fouled underneath.
Well, I really liked the call, but it was an interesting call in that I thought that time the official waited to see if Ryan was going to make the shot. He got bumped. He didn't really want to call it. And then when he missed, he realized, yeah, that bump affected the play.
Perhaps thinking, I've never seen Ryan Daly miss a shot that close before. He must have
maybe
been
maybe he's
fouled.
Been watching tape of Daly.
An
but,
excellent ball player.
It was a really interesting sequence there. The whistle came quite late. I thought Ryan deserved the foul initially.
Daly missing the first free throw, though. Delaware has been struggling from the free throw line. Second half of last game and now into this basketball game. Daly makes the second, 45-32, as Pruitt was trying to pass it in to Cone, and Mosley was there. He realized it, didn't let go of the ball, and then his foot went beyond the inbound line, so a turnover. Great defense by Champ Mosley.
A smart maneuver by Delaware to pick up. They did it also on the last possession as well, and William & Mary sent all their players up. Pruitt just got caught stepping in, trying to drop it. All Pruitt had to do was move along the baseline and give the ball to Cone.
And now the officials, Tim Ebersole at least, going to go over to the monitor and take a look at something. I'm not sure in this scenario what you would be looking for, but I think Pat Rogers is the director of operations here asking Matt Oblis what exactly they're checking for on the screen. But we do have a delay. Both teams going back to their bench. Get some team stats now as the Tribe shooting 52%, Delaware 39%. And we mentioned 7 three-pointers made by William & Mary, only 3 for Delaware. While we have a chance, one of our listeners, to join us for the next Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show, presented by First Aid Orthopedics, live from Klondike Cakes on Main Street. The next show can be heard from 7 to 8 p.m. on February 27th. Join Coach Martin Inglesby, Coach Tina Martin at Cates on your home for Blue Hens Basketball, 94.7 WDSD-FM. Cates under new ownership. It's brighter in there. They've got new wallpaper. They've got a new menu items. It is phenomenal. All the great things you've always loved about Klondike Cakes and a new menu, different portions of the menu now. Come join us on February 27th. A good time. Pretty good show, and Coach, you also get to see a lot of the other players that come as well. We always have two players, so we appreciate all that Klondike Cates does for us on Main Street. Don't know exactly still what they are looking for.
I didn't know this would be reviewable, the fact that Bernard Clinton got Pruitt for stepping in the court. Pruitt's argument was that he had dropped the ball in the court prior to stepping in.
They're looking right now at the free throw. As I have a pretty clear path to the monitor across, as Tim Ebersole still looking, and it's been rewinding, quite frankly, as I look at it for about 10 seconds now. And now they finally are fast forwarding to the inbound. So they are looking for an angle. They must be looking for an angle that has Omar Pruitt's foot in it. I've seen a body shot from the baseline camera, and Tim Ebersole comes away from the monitor.
I'm all for getting calls right, but it can't be disruptive to the flow of the play.
And it certainly has been. This is going to be Delaware basketball on their side of the floor. We just wasted 2 minutes of our life. I got a read in at least, though. Klondike Cates will be happy for the delay, but we're back in action. That is one of the things I can't stand about officials going to the monitors, is Bryant will get the basketball. It disrupts the flow of the basketball game. Bryant getting into the foul line. Inside to Carter, who bobbles the pass, and Knight saves it to a teammate, Daniel Dixon. Dixon on the run. No one stops him as he goes coast to coast and draws the foul by Eric Carter. And just to finish my statement there, what I would love is, at least when there's a stoppage in football, the officials have a microphone and kind of explain what was going on. We still have, as broadcasters, no idea what the stoppage was for. So that's unfortunate to our listeners. We wish we could kind of let you know what was going on there. But Dixon at the free throw line, and he is now 5 of 6 as he makes the first.
It's as if you are standing or sitting in a New York subway station and listening to them make a report on a subway you're waiting for, and I'll tell you, I did it for 17 years, and I still didn't figure one out.
Sound like that comes from experience there.
Delaware still getting hurt in transition. They're getting caught too far up the court and too expanded as William & Mary continues to probe right down the lane.
The two free throws from Dixon make it 47-32. Daly working hard to get inside. He draws contact and the foul. Daly very good on dribble penetration plays, drawing contact, and getting the free throw line. He's one of two today from the stripe. We'll get two more.
What makes him so dangerous is that he's a very good ball handler. He controls his body as he's going up, and he always attacks or always tries to attack the middle chest part of the shot block defender. And that time was Knight, who averages 1.5 blocks a game. He has not been able to get himself on track. Daly doing a nice job of attacking exactly when and where he should.
Knight with three fouls will take a seat. Daly makes the first free throw, misses the second. Uncharacteristic of Ryan Daly to miss two free throws in a basketball game. He's shooting 92% from the field over the last 12 contests. And now it's William & Mary basketball up 47-33, 17 minutes left in the basketball game. Cone picks up his dribble to Dixon on the wing. Bryant right there. And Bryant, a little too close for comfort, reached in and gets called for the foul.
That's a correct call, and Darian can make that correction very quickly. Instead of putting his hands inside his torso and his opponent's torso, keep them outspread, and that would help him in the defense of Dixon, who wants to drive it.
Bryant not having one of the games he's had as of late, as Malinowski fades on a three, misses, long rebound, tracked down by Eric Carter on the run. Daly has Pruitt in front of him, reversed by Daly, no good, poked around and will go the other way. Malinowski in the drive, 4-on-1, gives it to Pruitt, Pruitt double clutches, he misses, let's run the other way. Here comes Mosley, across half court to Daly, Cushing beyond the arc, corner to Daly, looking inside for Carter, instead cross court pass to Bryant, 21 to shoot, Mosley will slow things up, back to Darian, 19 to shoot, Cushing, as both teams just missed layups in transition. Daly eyes up a three and knocks it in. Delaware down 47-36.
The scouting report on Daly on those handoffs is you've got to jam the handoff or he will step back and drill it, and he is looking for that shot. William & Mary, a bad job there in understanding how to play Daly in the exchange.
Foul on the dribble drive. Cushing's going to be called for the foul. That will be his fourth, and that spells trouble for the freshman from Illinois. We'll take a break. 15:54 remaining, and the Tribe up 47-36 here in Newark, Delaware.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dark. Moving forward.
University of Delaware offers comprehensive clinical health and wellness services that are open to the public. Visit udel.edu/starhealth to learn more about a new direction in healthcare.
This is Blue Hens Country, 94.7 WDSD.
15:54 left to play at the Bob Carpenter Center, and the Tribe of William & Mary up 47-36, a large lead for a team that's won just two games on the road this season. They are 2-12 away from Kaplan Arena, where they have won 24 of their last 27. A different team on the road, but not tonight. Daniel Dixon has gotten them going. He's got 22. Pruitt with 10 to lead the way, and a foul by Jacob Cushing as he went to break is his fourth. He goes to the bench.
William & Mary's defense has definitely been more enthusiastic and engaged, and their offense has really hurt Delaware by the transition nature. Delaware's got to make that adjustment and be sure they have numbers back.
Daniel Dixon with the basketball, 20 to shoot for the Tribe, up by 11. Dixon calling for it, Pruitt on top to Whitman instead, straight away, one dribble and a pass to Pruitt. Pruitt at the foul line, Mosley pokes it away, the second leading steals man in the conference gets another one. Champ in the corner to Bryant, 25 to shoot. 15:30 to play. Pinkert's played well. He gets it to Daly. Daly straight away three. He's made two, but can't get another. Now 2 of 5 from beyond the arc. On the run out, it's Pruitt. Tried like to go fast. Pruitt to the rim, and on the way down, he got enough on the shot to get it in and draw the foul.
One of the problems with Delaware's transition defense is they're expecting spot-up shooters on the perimeter. Thus, there's nobody in the lane. William & Mary has changed their style, and now they're just going to go attack down in the lane because the Delaware defense is spaced out so much. So Delaware now has to clog the lane and then work out to shooters.
Pruitt at the stripe, where he's one of two today. 12 points for Omar Pruitt, averaging 15 points per game. He completes the three-point play. Pruitt was a first-team All-CAA preseason selection. Dixon was on the second team. Not so sure that won't switch as the awards are given out in a couple weeks at the end of the year. But both of them, All-CAA performers on the season. A former Rookie of the Year is Omar Pruitt as Delaware gets into their offense 5 minutes into the second half. Champ trying to draw some contact but doesn't get a whistle. Carter on offensive board. He misses, and then he fouls after the miss. Going over the back of Omar Pruitt.
It was a great effort by Eric Carter initially, and I think he just attacked a little too quickly. Sometimes you don't necessarily have to use a shot fake, but come down and get yourself on balance and then go back up and find a way to get the ball in the basket. I think he just played a little too fast, and then frustrated that he missed the first shot, goes over the back.
And this is concerning for Delaware as they pick up their seventh foul just about 5 minutes into the second half. 14:54 remaining, and William & Mary, a very good free throw shooting team individually, as a team under 70%, but they've got some guys that can knock it down in the 80%. So it's going to be tough the rest of the way, as it's 1-1 for the next two fouls and then double bonus for the Tribe.
And Delaware will now go uber small with Kasman Hayes in for Eric Carter. I'd expect some pressure. I'd expect a lot of ball movement out on the perimeter and see if we can't get some driving lanes exposed. We've got to get in there and get a lot of clock stoppages by getting the foul line.
We've got to get rebounds on misses of free throws. As Pruitt misses the second one, it gets back tapped to a Tribe player. Pruitt assist from David Cohn. I counted it too early. Omar Pruitt was alone underneath the basket and missed the layup. I gave Cohn the assist before the ball went in. It was a miss, but on the offensive board, another foul against Delaware. So Pruitt will try to get those two from the line. That's the fourth on Devon Pinkard here on senior night.
That's the second time Pruitt's made a weird-looking shot around the basket. It kind of reminded me of the player they had last year, Terry Tarpey, who used to get going so quickly that he seemed to lose the ball around the basket, though he was a great defender and terrific in the open court. Pruitt, very cagey. I really like his style of play. He's very smart, plays very hard at both ends.
We were able to talk to Omar Pruitt before the game, came over to the table, a nice young man that we've talked to throughout the years, but he's hoping to play some professional basketball next season. I think he has a good shot at doing so.
I agree with you. He's interested in playing in Germany. He's got some friends over there with some contacts, and we certainly wish him the best of luck.
53-36 is William & Mary piling on here, a 6-0 run over the last 30 seconds for the Tribe. Shabarsky Corbett in the game for the first time as Bryant gets it back to Champ. Corbett came in for Pinkard, who picked up his fourth. Kaz on the drive. Riley was there to foul him, and Kasman Hayes will shoot two. Kaz has been really struggling from the field, but he is 2-0-2 today from the free throw line. Can try to double that on this trip.
And that's exactly what you do when you don't feel comfortable and confident from the outside. You make a little shot fake or just immediately attack. Drive at the chest of the defender, get him off balance, and get a chance to get to the foul line. It also helps to score without the clock moving.
Kaz makes the free throw. Last game Kaz started was that William & Mary game down in Virginia. Starter tonight, Kaz's mom, Antwana, here. His grandmother here as well to see him play his final game as a senior at the Bob Carpenter Center.
I think with this group, Scott, we may see a little bit of full court pressure or half court pressure here.
I got a feeling that his family will be able to see him play, though, in a few days, though, as he's from Charlotte, North Carolina, and Delaware heads down to Raleigh area for the Elon matchup a week from today. Second free throw good, 53-38 remaining. Excuse me, 53-38 to score, 14-16 remaining. As the Tribe on offense operating with Cohn, top of the key. Rally to Daniel Dixon, NBA range three, and that's short, but an offensive board for Jack Whitman. Leads Cohn open in the corner. A couple of his teammates retreated on defense, a wait for his team to set up inside to Whitman, who had the hot advantage on Ryan Daly and gets the bucket and the foul.
Well, he sealed off Daly because the ball reversed so quickly that Ryan could not jump over the top. And David Cohn recognized that and delivered a perfect pass to Whitman, who was in great position to score.
Corbett was there helping, and he got called for his first. as Jack Whitman goes to the free throw line. Not a good free throw shooter at 59%, but he makes that one. And now 56-38 is the count. Delaware needs some answers offensively and some stops on the defensive side. Still a lot of basketball left at 13:48. Daly spinning in the lane to Hayes, a three from the left corner. That's good. And with that, Cass Hayes has passed Brian Pearl on the all-time three-point chart. That's some good company for the senior from Charlotte.
Yes, it is. I remember Brian Pearl playing. Played at a great speed, as smart a guard as we've seen here in a long time. That was a great setup play by Ryan Daly with a spin down the left side. Drew the help, Rowley off of Kasman Hayes, who delivered.
See if the Hens can't build off of that make as Dixon goes inside. Brian turned his head at the last moment defending on Daniel Dixon.
I think he was looking for help.
Layup goes through on the other end. Mosley draws contact in the whistle. He'll go to the free throw line for two. That's just the fifth on William & Mary. Delaware has been called for nine.
As much as Delaware doesn't have much of a post presence and an interior defense influence, neither does William & Mary. Whitman is not known as a good post defender. Mosley understanding that and attacking and getting himself to the foul line.
Mosley tied with Barnett Harris is the top free throw shooter on the team, both at 76%. Mosley makes the first free throw. Delaware didn't shoot well from the stripe in the first half, but it was better this half as they are 6 of 8. Harris will check in as Bryant goes to the bench. So Harris, Mosley, Hayes, Corbett, and Daly on the floor for Delaware. Tott comes in for the Tribe, Pruitt to the bench. Justin Pearson as well. So Tott, Pierce, Malinowski, Dixon, and Whitman on the floor for William & Mary, trying to pick up their third road win of the season.
Malinowski has struggled tonight. Usually a very good spot-up shooter. He seemed to be off balance and out of rhythm.
Just one of five today from three is Malinowski. Usually a 43% three-point shooter. Delaware down 58-43 after Mosley makes the free throws. Dixon being pressured beyond the arc. 16 to shoot as he gets to the foul line. Kick out Malinowski on the wing. Inside to Dixon. Dixon guarded by Hayes. Flips it to Whitman. Whitman shot rejected by Kasman Hayes. His 20th of the season.
Whitman had the ball as he drop-stepped in after a really nice pass by Daniel Dixon. Had the ball too far away from his body, and that allowed Kasman Hayes to run through and knock it away.
Hayes leads all guards in blocked shots in the CAA and leads Delaware as just a 6'4 senior, great defender. 7 to shoot, he'll defend Dixon. Dixon, off balance, off the window, off the mark. Pierce with an offensive board, though. He missed so far off that it just landed in Justin Pierce's hands for the offensive board, and he gets fouled on the putback.
It was almost as if that shot was really a pass, though that was not intended. Dixon usually takes really good shots within the confines of the offense. That was one that I think he'd probably like to have back.
Just his third miss of the night, 7 of 10 after that one. Corbett picks up his second foul. Pierce at the free throw line, good. A lot of free throws going to be taken by William & Mary the rest of the night as they're in the double bonus, 12:44 left and a 59-43 lead.
Coach Shaver, as well as Coach Inglesby, have done a nice job of moving players in and out, getting a lot of rest. Even Ryan Daly has gotten some additional rest here this evening. And that's one of the keys. Coaching is not as easy as it looks. And to manage those rotations and the minutes and to find a time to get a player like Pruitt or Daly out or Dixon to provide them with extra energy down the stretch are very smart. And it takes a very well-organized coach to do that.
Daly of three. Must be those 2 minutes he sat out. Fresh legs for Ryan Daly. And the Hens within 13.
Malinowski, usually a pretty good defender, and since he's such a good three-point shooter, he should know he was too far off Daly that time.
Want to go back to the free throw before Ryan Daly's three. It was a lane violation against Malinowski. They gave the ball back to Delaware. So 12:14 remaining. Hands down 59-46, make it 61-46 as Whitman. The screen and slip, an assist from Pierce, another layup for William & Mary. Ryan Daly with 15 points to lead Delaware. He has the basketball. Between the legs dribble. Pass over to Champ in front of Delaware's bench. He drives, passes defender. Tott lays it up with the left hand.
Well, Tott does not understand that Anthony Mosley is heavily left-handed, and William & Mary has not done a good job here in the second half of the 9-lane entries by Delaware.
Hens have made their last 3 shots from the field. Now they need to defend. Pierce guarded by Corbett, who has 2 fouls. 15 to shoot. Corner goes to Malinowski. Back to Dixon, who has 24. Whitman on top, left wing, left corner. Malinowski could get the shot off. Daly was there. Barnett Harris hedging on the screen, diving for the basketball. It's loose. Daniel Dixon, he called timeout without possession of the basketball. They'll give it to William and Mary. And I don't know if that shouldn't be, I don't know if it is reviewable, but Daniel Dixon, I don't think he had the basketball with Harris diving, Kasman Hayes in the area. They give the possession to William and Mary, but if I'm Delaware, hey, take it, because there's 2 seconds on the shot clock. You'll probably get the ball back and keep the arrow. We'll take a break, though, with 11:22 remaining here at the Bob Carpenter Center, and William Mary up 61-48. Back in a moment.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
We went to break. Barnett Harris poked down to the hands of Daniel Dixon. It went back court, and then Barnett Harris dove for the basketball. Kasman Hayes was there, as was Daniel Dixon, who dove on it. Called a timeout, but where he called the timeout was near the Delaware three-point line with 2 seconds on the shot clock. So that's where Omar Pruitt will inbound right in front of you, Bill. They've got 2 seconds to get a shot off as we resume action. Pruitt looking down the floor. Baseball pass to Dixon. Catch, shoot, three. It's short and a rebound by Devon Pickard. So the timeout keeps the arrow the way of Delaware as Kasman Hayes drives back to Devon. Mosley, elbow left, driving on Dixon, and Anthony Mosley doing a nice job of getting to the foul line in this second half. Second time he's been fouled off the dribble drop.
Mosley imposing his will. He looks much more dynamic tonight with the dribble. He's taking better care of the basketball. He's playing quick, but he never seems to be in a hurry. And I really like the pace at which he's played this evening.
Mosley, Delaware's second leading scorer, just 0.2 under double figures on the season. Free throw good. Delaware trails 61-49. Anthony has registered more assists than turnovers in three of the last five games. That's significant because he had not done so in the 13 games prior. He had 7 assists, tied for a season and career high against Drexel on Thursday night. And the second free throw good from Champ, 61-50. Now the count.
Delaware's defense is kind of bringing him back. Some hustle plays, better defense around the rim. Kasman Hayes with an energy play on a potential dunk by Whitman.
Here's Dixon, and now Hayes knocks it away, gets the steal. Mosley on the run out. It's 3-on-3. Champ, Euro step, and he was too far underneath to complete the layup. Omar Pruitt with the rebound.
Well, that was a shame because Mosley really had great recognition of how to avoid the shot blocker.
Now Knight on the other end. Entry pass from Pruitt. Daly called for the foul as Knight couldn't make the layup, and he'll go to the free throw line where this season he is a 64% free throw shooter.
One of these underrated points is that William and Mary is very athletic and very fast. They move the ball up the court very rapidly. They're willing to do it via the pass very often, throwing the ball ahead. But when they dribble it, they have fast players who do a great job of forcing the defense back very quickly. And if they're not organized, they take advantage of it.
Knight misses the free throw. Third on Ryan Daly. He's got 3, 4 for Pinkard, Carter, and Cushing. So a lot of key contributors in this basketball game. In foul trouble. Ryan Daly with the rebound. Ryan Daly, now the all-time leading rebounder for freshmen in Delaware history, passing Barry Berger, who played his freshman year in the 1984-85 season.
William & Mary playing a little bit of the 3-2 zone that they like to use from time to time to slow down Delaware's attack and also stay out of foul trouble.
Pinkert missing on a jump shot, and Mosley gets called for the foul as Tot across half court.
bad place, especially when you're in the have given the other team the double bonus to make a foul. You want to be aggressive, but at that point, so far extended, you just can't ill afford to foul.
Tat, as Delaware's been in the double bonus now for quite some time. 12th foul against Delaware this half. We'll go to the free throw line. And William Mary, if they make their free throws, it's going to be tough. It's going to be tough for Delaware the rest of the way.
Well, one of the keys to winning on the road is to take and make more foul shots than your opponent. Right now, they're definitely doing that.
12-point lead for the Tribe. Back to 13 as Tot knocks in a pair. Tribe 13 of 17 from the line in this second half. Hayes against the 2-3 zone of William & Mary. Back on top to Champ. Champ to Kasman Hayes. Season opening, kicks in the corner. Daly contested three off the mark and a rebound by the freshman Knight.
Good long arm contest by Omar Pruitt, who read that one correctly.
Pruitt drives. Cushing playing with four, and Pruitt gets the roll. Hit the front rim and spun in for Omar Pruitt as his team up by 15, and Delaware wants to take a timeout. 9:44 remaining in the contest. 65-50 is the count. William & Mary up by 15, and as Delaware takes the break, we'll give you some scores from around the CAA as UNC Wilmington beat Hofstra 83-76. Chris Flemings had 27 points in that one. The CAA tournament player of the tournament a season ago down in Baltimore. Justin Wright Foreman had 26 points for Hofstra. Charleston is 12-4 in the CAA. They remain in second place after Joe Chile scored 29 points in that one. Jarrell Brantley, last year's Rookie of the Year, had 21. One of the players that will be an all-rookie team selection, Grant Riller, had 21 as well for Charleston. 85-71 win for the Cougars. Elon beat Drexel 65-56 up in Philadelphia. Elon now 9-7 on the year. Dane and Swoop had 21 points. Tyler Sebring 14 for the Phoenix. And right now, James Madison on the road at Towson. The Tigers up 59-49 in the second half. 7 minutes left in that one. Back in action, Darian Bryant at the point guard position. Hayes, Daly, Mosley, and Carter coming out of the timeout for Delaware, down by 15.
William & Mary still in this zone. It's not confounding Delaware, but we need more ball movement.
Hayes, a wing three, way off the mark from Kasman Hayes, who is, I say it every game, but worth mentioning, a 24% three-point shooter, despite how many leave the hand of Kasman Hayes. Omar Pruitt underneath after a wraparound pass from Nathan Knight, and things starting to get a little bit out of hand. A 17-point lead for William & Mary.
We talk about Pruitt being so dangerous on the perimeter and also in transition, but he has really hurt Delaware tonight inside.
Bryant with the basketball. Hayes now on the wing. Corner to Daly. Step back. Has Knight on him. Over to Hayes. Cross court to Mosley. Touch pass to Bryant. Wing right side. Corner right side. Mosley. Seven to shoot. Champ. Hop step. Corner. Daly. Daly lets Birchfield pass. Sets his feet. Squares and hits.
Hard run by Birchfield, and then a high hand contest by Pruitt, who also was late. Ryan Daly, really smart there, kind of relocating himself on the perimeter for that big time three.
Ryan Daly, 18 points so far to lead Delaware. Double figures in 19 of his last 21. Pruitt turns from the foul line, misses, a rebound for Darian Bryant, approaching the 8-minute mark. Daly ahead, hop step, taken away by Pruitt. It goes out of bounds along the baseline. It'll stay with Delaware as Daly tried to catch the Tribe napping, but they got back on deep.
Ryan Daly is very dangerous in that maneuver because he is a good ball handler, he's got good body control, and he's so physical that he will initiate contact, and many times the defender has no choice but to back off. That time Pruitt just a little too alert.
Bad inbound pass by Darian Bryant. Threw it right to a Tribe player at the top of the arc. It was Justin Pierce. Now on the other end, Pierce with three. Can't connect. Rebound by Eric Carter. That's a seventh for the sophomore.
Well, Birchfield was wide open on the right side, and he thought he should have received the ball. A little bit of talking to there on that pass to the other side to a less used reserve in Pierce.
Letting his freshman know he wants the rock. 67-53 Tribe. Defending on Ryan Daly, but a foul is called on the dribble move, and we'll take a timeout. 7:45 remaining. Hens, a lot of work to get back in this one against the Tribe. 67-53 here in Newark.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart. Moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your
guide. Back in the WDSD studios, one of our listeners that nothing great was built on an empty stomach. Dash In now offers all new breakfast sandwiches on a warm buttery croissant roll. Grab a 16-ounce Dash In coffee and a breakfast sandwich for only $3.50. As we went to break, Delaware was fouled. It was the seventh foul on William and Mary, the second on Justin Pierce, the freshman. He fouled another freshman, Ryan Daly, who's two free throws away from his ninth 20-point game of the year.
Ryan Daly has that unique ability to find ways to help his team offensively, whether it be a spot-up three on a relocate, getting fouled, getting to the foul line by driving the ball, offensive rebounds, etc.
Daly misses the front end of the one-and-one, though, and a rare poor performance by Daly at the free throw line. Just 2 of 5 today. The first non-conference portion of the season as Birchfield shoots a three and makes one wide open. Daly shot poorly from the free throw line. He improved his 92% over the last several games, but struggling today. Birchfield's first shot attempt of the contest, and it goes through.
And Delaware had switched to a zone there and had no idea where Birchfield was, who is one of their best shooters off the bench.
Daly corner, Bryant to three in front of the Delaware bench off the mark. Carter is there. It fell right into his chest, and he put it back up and through.
And he did that because he got position, but not one block out by William and Mary. Everybody just watched the ball go up. I was looking at their underneath coverage.
Now Daly picks the pocket of Pruitt. It's 2-on-2. Daly has Birchfield in front. Birchfield fouls him. Daly too much. Gets it in, and the foul.
Well, Pruitt's too smart a player to cross over on another very intelligent player. Ryan Daly was looking for it and then finishes through Birchfield, who had no opportunity to stop him at the other end.
70-57. Daly at the stripe, missed another one. That one was short right off his hand. You could tell that wasn't going in.
Didn't get that knee flexion that he had talked to us about, and sometimes he just doesn't get his elbow extended enough.
He's missed 4 free throws, 2 of 6. Delaware struggled last game on Thursday despite the win against Drexel from the line. And today, just 63% as a team. Tot wraparound pass inside tonight, and he is fouled plus one. Tot found his big man inside, and Knight do the rest.
Oliver Tot doing a nice job there of recognizing where the defense was as he came out of the spin move, delivered a perfect underhanded wraparound pass to the big man who finished from a tough angle.
Foul goes against Ryan Daly. That's his fourth, so 4 for Daly, Carter, Pinkard, and Cushing. And there's still 6:31 remaining. Daly going to stay in the basketball game as Knight makes the free throw, finishes up the three-point play. 73-57. William Mary just 2 of 2 and 12 on the road this season, but looking like they're on their way to their third victory, unless the Hens can do something in the next 6 minutes. Corner three, Hayes missing. And Casman Hayes from downtown has made just 6 of his last 32 threes over the past 10 contests.
And there was absolutely no Delaware offensive rebounder anywhere in the vicinity of the basket.
It's not a good looking shot for the senior here on senior night. Pruitt, cross-court pass from Dixon, 10 to shoot for the senior. He backs out in front of Tony Shaver and the William & Mary bench. 6 seconds. Inside, Knight, they lost him. Knight spins and scores again.
Well, that's exactly what you do when confronted by a double team. Instead of dribbling into it, you retreat dribble and then look for the basket. Pruitt did that exceptionally well there, locating his big man for a layup.
75-57 now. Bryant into the lane, shoots over a shot blocker at Knight. It sits on the back of the rim and falls through. Soft touch for Darian Bryant. Only his fourth point, though. Bryant had previously scored in double figures in six of the last seven games.
Well, it's good to see Darian kind of getting back into the flow offensively. He's been a little out of rhythm this evening.
5:19 to go. 75-59. Harris fouls David Cole. And again, double bonus for most of this half. 14th foul against Delaware, so Cone will shoot two.
And Cone is an exceptional free throw shooter. What I like about Cone's game is that he doesn't need to score to enjoy playing the game. He'd rather push the ball, set up his teammates. He plays solid defense, and he can help finish out games getting to the free throw line.
Cone fifth in the CAA in assists at 4.5 per contest. He's got four today. No turnovers for Cone. This is the free throw. Cone going to be back next year. Transfer from Colorado State. Played well as a sophomore and now in his redshirt junior year for Tony Shaver. Pinkert, Cushing, and Mosley going to check in. Harris, Hayes, and Corbett going to check out.
Scott, it feels to me like Martin's kind of searching for a lineup rotation this evening. And I don't think the senior night threw him off. It's just the way this game has gone. He's kind of looking for that locked-in group that can get him back into the game.
Yeah, I agree with that. The starters that usually have been starting as of late during this win streak did not start tonight, and he's kind of been searching with a different flow of substitutions tonight. Nobody really stopping William and Mary. Cushing drives inside to Mosley. Not very good spacing, but knocked out by Whitman. He'll stay with Delaware. 76-59. Hens have won three games in a row. And here on senior night, just under five left, down by 17.
Well, this is a dangerous team to play. I know they haven't played well on the road this year, but they still have a lot of fine players, and I can see them early on tonight getting their transition offense going and the free flow of their Princeton-style offense.
Daly misses on a three. Back to William and Mary. 19 seconds to shoot for the try. Birchfield thought about the three, then stolen away by Daly as he thought better of it. On the run out, Bryant, he misses another layup. That's the second time Darren Bryant, who's struggling tonight, has missed something at the rim. Dixon on the other end, fouled by Pinkert, and that'll end his career at the Bob Carpenter Center. Fifth foul for Devon Pinkert, who started this one so strong in the first half. 10 points for Devon Pinkert, but that's his fifth foul, and he'll have to go take a seat.
Well, I remember fondly Devon Pinkert's off-the-ball defense, a lot of deflections, a good weak side rebounder, and the ability to knock down early on in his career some really long-range, timely threes. As his career went on, he might have lost a little bit of that shooting touch, but he's still a fine young man, always played very hard in his minutes, and one of the better defenders Delaware has.
Dixon misses the free throw. Pinkert to the bench. A lot of family members here for Devon Pinkert, J.P. McCaskey High School, Lancaster, Pennsylvania native. Among them is dad Phil, his mom Carissa, in attendance tonight at the Bob Carpenter Center.
It's great to see all his friends and family down. He's a really fine young man who I have high hopes for in the next chapter in his life.
Anthony Mosley. Mosley a float shot, and he misses. Rebound to William and Mary. Daniel Dixon, guarded by Bryant. Corner goes to Cone. Inside, Omar Pruitt, left block, working on Daly. He's got four fouls and a traveling violation called against Omar Pruitt. It's a timeout on the floor. But we're going to stay here with 3:53 remaining. 77-59 is the count. William and Mary getting it done on the offensive side and doing a great job defensively. Just not the night, it seems, for the Delaware Blue Hens.
I thought from the outset William and Mary's defense was better than I had expected it to be. That's been one of their weaknesses on the road. They have not been shooting the ball well on the road for a variety of reasons. Maybe good defense at different confines, though this is a team that has enough experience that they've been in these different arenas. Not the same night they had shooting that we encountered down at in Williamsburg in January, but they're still shooting over 50% from the field, 42 from the three, and that's been one of the real bugaboos of Delaware's defense is our inconsistency of guarding the three-point line. But I thought William and Mary really got confident when they got their transition offense going. Pruitt hurt us countless times in the first half running the court. Delaware just could never figure out whether to guard the space or guard the lane, and that really plagued us this evening. And William and Mary took advantage of it, and they're a good enough team offensively to do that and to understand how the other team's defending you and to take advantage of it. So I'm just going to say better offense by William and Mary combined with a much more engaged defense.
3:53 left in this one, and get some stats inside the box score. Ryan Daly, 20 points on the night. He's ninth 20-point performance of the season. 25 points for Daniel Dixon. Omar Pruitt with 20. Both players, 7 of 11 from the field. William & Mary shooting 51% in this contest. Nobody else in double figures for William & Mary. 7 points for Whitman, 7 for Knight, who's had a solid freshman campaign, and 7 points for Carter, 8 for Mosley. The other two leading scorers that are still eligible. Pinkard has fouled out. He's got 10 points, second leading scorer on the night for Delaware.
One thing that William & Mary's bench does, though, it provides them points without high-volume shooting, which allows Dixon and Pruitt and other players such as Malinowski to shoot a little bit more.
Bryant, cross-court pass. He hasn't been himself tonight. Ball stolen. Cone layup over Jacob Cushing, who was rushing back.
Well, Cone is a very smart off-the-ball defender. He's very quick, read that pass because he's a point guard, knows how players are delivering passes.
Cross-court pass again. This time Cushing connects on it. Foul line, it's Carter. Carter, head fake, jump shot, short rebound. Champ Mosley, kick out Daly, open for a three. Ryan Daly can't connect, and a miss into the hands of Jack Whitman for William & Mary.
Good activity inside by Delaware to get the ball back out to Daly. We're still fighting hard, but William & Mary's just going to be too good here this evening.
I'll tell you what, William & Mary goes inside to Dixon. Dixon, pump fake, gets Bryant off his feet, misses the layup, and a rebound by Bryant. Good defensive effort that time by Darian Bryant. Now Bryant on the run, corner to Cushing, extra pass to Daly. Daly back to Bryant, who's calling for it. He squares, releases on a three, around and out, and a rebound for Dixon. But William Mary, I mean, based on the two games that I've seen against Delaware, I know they'll be 9-7 on the year in CAA play, but I wouldn't be surprised if Tony Shaver's team ends up playing on Sunday or Monday, as they always seem to be doing.
Well, I think that's a great point. This team's offense is rated fairly high in the country in its efficiency in points per possession and also the number of possessions they get in a game because of their free flow aspect. They share the ball extremely well. That's one thing I like. They have 21 assists and 21 made field goals, and that's kind of the epitome of the Princeton offense.
Omar Pruitt, a three, and he's been a big part of the offense for William Mary over the past 4 years. 23 points on 8 of 12 shooting for Omar Pruitt. Tribe on a 7-0 run. They lead 82-59. Curtis McCroy in the game, as he was a starter for the 7th time in his career. We told Curtis, or I told Curtis at least, if he touches the basketball in this basketball game, let it fly. It's his last one here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Team turns it over, down 82-59. If he touches it on the offensive side of half court, he's got to let that thing shoot. That's what I told him.
Well, he hasn't taken your advice.
He hasn't. He's
just
a team
too good
player.
He's a team player.
That's for sure. And Curtis Lochner coming in. The family of Curtis McCroy here as well. His dad, Scott. His mom, Carol. His brother, Connor, played UD Lax. And his brother, Casey, in the stands as well, rocking a beard. If it weren't for the beard, I would have thought that Curtis McCroy was watching the game from the stands. He's away from us. His brother, Casey, looks exactly like him, identical to Curtis McCroy. But always good to see his family and the family of the seniors at these basketball games. And as we talked at the top of the show and the pregame show, all four of these seniors have been just a pleasure to be around.
So many little things that you remember about players, but the one that I'll always remember about Curtis McCroy, he has a terrific handshake. He looks you in the eye and always speaks to you. It's either hello, coach, or whatever. But I really like him. He's got great manners, obviously raised extremely well by his family, and I think that's going to go an awful long way in his life.
Timeout on the floor from William & Mary to get some substitutions in. Rowley back on the floor, as is Pierce. His pass ricochets off the side of the backboard to Birchfield. Pierce with 4 on the shot clock, lets it fly, misses, and a rebound for Kasman Hayes. Over off the floor, Jacob Cushing ahead of the pack. 90 seconds left on senior night. Curtis Lochner trying to find Curtis McCroy. McCroy with the basketball, stops, finds Cushing. Cushing with 19. Delaware has missed their last 6 shots from the field. Here's McCroy. Step back over to Hayes. Hayes with 13. He drives, and a foul's going to be called on Oliver Tott.
Well, Curtis could have clearly listened to you there. He had an opportunity for a little step-back shot. But being the really good teammate that he is, he sets up another old guy, Kasman Hayes, who has throughout his career always impressed me with his athleticism, his ability to drive the ball, some very timely weak side rebounding, and some terrific on the ball defense.
Jameson Glover will check in for William & Mary. The junior doesn't play much, 21 career games, and he'll get a chance to come in. Also Michael Schlottman, a redshirt junior, who's not used very much by Tony Shaver, enters the game, and Omar Mostafa will play again. Mostafa doesn't even have his name on the back of his jersey. We got to fix that for Omar, a freshman from Saddle River, New Jersey. Made his first career CAA appearance against Delaware on January 26th, and here he is again.
Don Bosco Prep, a tremendous football program up in northern New Jersey. I'm not familiar with their basketball one. I'm sure it's probably pretty good.
Free throw good from Kasman Hayes. In fact, he made both of them, 82-61, as Schlottman goes underneath. Baseline pass to Pierce, stolen away by McCrory. Ahead of the pack to Kasman Hayes. Hayes gets the layup with the right hand, and Kasman Hayes enjoys a senior night that has led him to 11 points, double-figure scoring in his final home contest.
And a great pass by Curtis McCrory, who could have driven it himself, but saw Curtis Hayes outside on the right side and delivered a perfect pass to him in stride.
82-63, under a minute. William & Mary going to improve the 9-7 in conference play. Their 15th win of the season, 12 losses. Delaware will snap a three-game winning streak. Cross-court pass to Mostafa. A three is good for the walk-on, and the Tribe bench loving it.
And that was an old-time set shot. There was absolutely no difference between his shoes and the floor on that shot.
Hayes with the basketball. Let's get the ball to Curtis McCrory. Harris, right block. He spins, and he's fouled.
Barnett just wheeling into that right shoulder, trying to dunk the ball. Still plays, no matter what the score of the game is, with wonderful intensity, locked in focus, great enthusiasm for the game. Maybe one of the great Delaware teammates of all time. There isn't a player on the team that wouldn't tell you that he's their best teammate. A great communicator in practice. I don't think I've ever heard a player talk more in practice, I mean in the right way. And he's always locked in and gives a great effort.
One of the things I told Barnett, as he's always nice enough to come over and speak with us before the game, is, you know, I know for these seniors, this season didn't go the way they had planned, but they can never take away that NCAA tournament appearance and that CAA championship their freshman year. A lot of players play college basketball. Not many get to play in the NCAA tournament. This senior class did just that as freshmen back in 2014. They can't take that away.
But Scott, we got to see those Spokane Falls.
That's right, as the Hens play Michigan State out in Washington. That'll do it for this one. 85-64, the final, as William & Mary comes on the road and gets a victory for just the third time in 15 tries this year. We'll take a break. When we come back, the American Spirit Federal Credit Union post-game show from Newark, Delaware. Back in a moment.